We now move on to leaders' questions, and I call on Deputy Micheál Martin.
Thank you very much indeed, Ciarán Cóirle. Taoiseach, the storms of the last week in particular have devastated families, homes, businesses, farmers and entire towns. Storm Desmond has in particular wreaked havoc and severe dislocation in Bandon, County Cork, in Ballinasloe, in Ballybofey and Crossmolina in particular. And there's been a very serious impact and potential impact still on the Shannon, the entire Shannon region and a number of other counties. Roads, schools and many facilities remain closed as a result of the damage caused. And listening and speaking to councillors across the country, I think for those who are not affected, it's difficult to comprehend the impact these storms have had on so many communities and so many people and the depth of the destruction that has been caused. And the problem is that some of these communities have been hit before, back in 2009 and indeed in 2013. As a result, for example, many can't access insurance. These communities are very angry, Taoiseach, and they do feel let down by government and by authorities in general. They feel there's a lack of urgency and proactivity in prioritising the capital flood relief works. 1,500 people marched in Bandon last evening, and Councillor Catherine Murphy O'Mahony rang me to say and summed it up that enough is enough. And Councillor Margaret Murphy O'Mahony was very clear on that and has been speaking to many people in the community there. But what is worrying, Taoiseach, is that the funding allocation remains, a significant degree of it, unspent for flood relief works. For 2015, $87 million was provided, Taoiseach. $60 million of that was capital, $61 million. But up to the end of October, only $35 million of that was actually spent. And incredibly, Taoiseach, for 2016, the budget is at $73 million. $44 million is only capital, Taoiseach. So we're actually going to spend less in 2016 than was provided for in 2015. And that's what gives rise to the sense of people feeling there's a lack of real proactivity and urgency about this. And finally, Taoiseach, Deputy Keaveney questioned Minister Harris over a month ago about the situation in Peterswell and the need for a drainage works there. And the Minister replied that the reason money was not provided was that no one could see the benefit from it. Well, if you spoke to the people in that area now, Taoiseach, they could tell you about the benefits that would have accrued if that money was spent on relatively minor works that would have saved the schools and the houses from enormous damage there. So, Taoiseach, can you indicate to me when will action be taken to ensure that the flood relief works in the areas worst affected will take place and will go ahead?
Thank you.
And can you indicate if the government has emergency measures to deal with the lack of insurance that people are finding at the moment, the lack of access to insurance to enable them to deal with the situation? And thirdly, how do you propose to allocate the humanitarian relief funding? We've had previous episodes of this
Thank
when
you.
The money doesn't
Thank
actually
you.
Get to people, and there's anxiety about how that's going to be administered.
Taoiseach.
Thank you, Deputy Martin, for his comments. Obviously, this is an ongoing situation, and it's not the first time it's happened. Clearly, on behalf of everybody in the House, I'd like to empathise with the people in their homes who have been devastated by the impact of serious flooding, and by those in businesses, and those in the agricultural area whose lands have been flooded, causing difficulties for the movement of stock and the feeding of stock and so on. I'd also like to say that we should express our sympathy to the family of the late Ivan Vaughan, who was caught in the floodwaters in Callan in County Tyrone, Cancorla. I think it's fair to say, Deputy Martin, that most areas are on high alert. The Shannon's a slow-moving river. Obviously, it takes a number of days for situations to evolve here. And Ballina was on high alert for fear that the high tide and the surging waters would overflow the walls, but it didn't actually happen. Rainfall for November exceeded 50% above average. OPW reported that many rivers were at bank level before the rainfall started on Friday. November was a wet month in many areas. Ground was exceptionally saturated. One-fifth of the country drains through the Shannon, so it's expected that the lower estuary will be in spate and flood later this week. Further episodes of rain and wind are forecast, and there may well be further instances and episodes of flooding. And experience indicates that the waters will not recede for days and many weeks, and indeed months in some cases. Now, local authorities and supporting agencies remain in very high alert in terms of response, and the National Coordination Committee meets again today to assess threat assessments at national level. I'd say to you that in the past 20 years, the governments invested $410 million on flood relief schemes. In comparison to that, there'll be over $430 million spent on flood risk in the coming 6 years, which is part of the capital programme set out there, schemes that are either under construction or at design stage, with flood relief works to be carried out in various locations. Clearly, Mallow, Fermoy, Clonmel and other areas have been quite successful, but then again, weather may dictate heavier rainfall at different times in those areas. I met with the chairman of the National Coordination Group yesterday to receive a report, discuss the matter with both Minister Coveney and Minister Harris, and the government considered the situation at today's meeting at Concorla. There are a number of actions that have been taken immediately. For homes that are affected, the Department of Social Protection have a humanitarian fund of $10 million, which was sanctioned by government back in 2012, but not drawn down, which is available for emergency assistance and will be deployed. And community welfare officers are now actually calling to the homes of people in towns that are flooded, across Crossmolina, Bandon and other locations. So the staff from the Department of Social Protection are on the ground in the affected areas, and there's a three-stage process for immediate relief in respect of whether the house is habitable, what are the needs immediately in terms of basic cash for basic requirements, and once the water has been pumped out or flooded, a flood removed, what the longer-term assessment of the house is. I might say to you, Deputy Martin, that for businesses in towns affected at the weekend, the government has allocated $5 million this morning to be distributed as emergency assistance to small businesses who, through no fault of their own, have suffered flood damage and have not been able to take out flood insurance. Now, I expect, Concorla, that the assessments for those will take place in the coming days with a view to making arrangements to whatever extent assistance can be given in the immediate future. Finally, I might say that the Department of Agriculture have put in place a number of measures to deal with the movement of animals from flooded land to sensitively take into account flood damage when carrying out farm inspections, and also in respect of making arrangements for the transportation of slurry from flooded slurry tanks. The government will receive a full report on this during the course of this week, and again at its meeting next week, on the damage and the scale of what has emerged, both for roads and bridges and other issues that are not been assessed yet, in the same way as happened just a few years ago when the major storms hit. So again, Concorla, we empathise with the difficulties that people faced just a few weeks before Christmas, but the immediate response is as I've outlined for Deputy Martin.
Genuinely, I don't want to make a political issue of this, but I have to say, you know, you gave a good weather forecast. That's important that people know what's coming down the tracks. But I get the sense in the towns affected, people want to know when action's going to happen. You know, Bandon was very badly flooded in 2009. The relief scheme hasn't happened. The capital works hasn't been put in place. I was reading the Irish Examiner, February 26, 2014. saying the slow-paced attempts, it says, to protect vulnerable communities after the January 2014 storms ravaged the country were revealed by officials tasked with overseeing the funding yesterday. That was an account of a public accounts meeting well over a year ago, Taoiseach. The slow-paced attempts, that kind of sums up the official response to the flooding crisis in our country. And I know in the context of what was an uninspiring speech on climate change, there is a real sense that government doesn't get it in terms of what's happening. And I would say, Taoiseach, that this needs to be dramatically upgraded in terms of priority.
Thank you.
Because you summed it up there, Taoiseach. You actually said yourself the humanitarian relief scheme came in 2012, 10 million, mostly not drawn down. It's not drawn down. So that scheme isn't working. Ask anybody in an area. I remember in Cork City, we sent off hundreds of applications because of the dam that was released that time, and going on and on. No one got anything, Taoiseach. So there's no confidence in something like humanitarian relief. People won't even bother applying. So there's no point in coming in saying, you know, 2012, we put 10 million, but no one actually drew it down, so therefore it's still the same scheme. Something isn't working. The insurance issue, Taoiseach, needs new measures. It could be joint government-backed insurance programmes for flood areas. Because even in areas like Clonmel, where good schemes were brought in and initiated and are now in a better position than previously, they're still finding it difficult to get insurance, Taoiseach. The key issue, though, is next year we'll be spending less on flood relief, capital flood relief works than last year. That kind of sums up, in my view, the lack of prioritisation. So can you give me an indication, Taoiseach, that the actual capital works that are required will go ahead? And can you give me some indication of the timescale? And in relation to Deputy Keaveney's parliamentary question to Minister Harris, where he actually specified the works that were to be done, if that had been done, a lot of the damage might not have been averted that has occurred. And if you could undertake to have that reviewed and an inquiry carried out into that as to how that situation was allowed to unfold.
Yeah, well, I disagree with you when you say that you get the sense that the government doesn't appreciate this. Don't you understand that we've had all the reports collated from the local authorities, from people on the ground in the towns that are flooded, in the businesses that are flooded, and from many other sources. Schemes that are at construction stage now are the River Wad in Clanmoyle in Dublin, which is nearly completed, from Moyle South down in Cork. The scheme is completed and operational. Ennis Lower is completed. Waterford Phase 2, 3 and 4 is substantially completed. South Campshire is in Dublin to be completed in 2016. Bray to be completed in late 2016, early 2017. And the River Dodder Phase 2C, 2D, 2E to be completed in 2016, early 2017. Schemes that are likely to go to construction in 2016 are Temple Moor, Clare Galway, Bandon County Cork, Skibbereen County Cork and Fines County Limerick. You will have heard the Minister of State clarify that we lost 2 years with legal objections to the tender process for Bandon. And while people are perfectly entitled to make objections, those have now been overcome, and the Minister has given his commitment on that. Obviously...
Sorry, please, yeah. We're over.
In respect time. In respect of the works that you say, the capital works, the tender documentation issued to a shortlist of contractors, they're due back in early January for Bandon. The assessment process will take place. The scheme will be constructed between 2016 and 2018. The main elements are the new walls and embankments, excavating the channel by approximately 1.6 metres for a distance of 3.5 kilometres, replacement of the pedestrian bridge, underpinning Bandon Bridge, construction of new fish passages and the associated drainage works, including new pump stations, and that's in place. I might say that the scheme that was designed for Crossmore Line, which had its worst flooding in 52 years, means that the bridge in through the centre of the town is incapable of taking flood waters and may have to be replaced completely. The Office of Public Works are currently refining a preferred option for the Cross Malina flood relief scheme. But on the ground, Cancola, the humanitarian prospects from the situation from the Department of Social Protection are already there. It's in three phases. Immediate assessment, if people have to be moved to accommodation. The provision of cash for the immediate situation in any house and the longer term analysis of when the water is actually pumped out.
Thank you.
The same will apply in respect of assessments now on the $5 million allocated for businesses in the towns, and this is now open in respect of both Crossmolina and Bandon and the other locations that have been flooded in the last few days. Clearly, Deputy Martin, next week we'll have a further report on other areas that have been damaged, bridges and roads and so on like that.
Deputy Adams.